Students, in the last lecture, I told you about the functioning of the secondary market and its limitations. Okay, now in today's class, we will be taking a new topic which is called orders and the types of orders. Now, I told you that the investors in the stock market cannot trade directly, rather, they have to trade via a broker or a brokerage firm to sell or purchase securities. Okay, so orders are instructions that the investors will give to the brokers in order to buy or sell. So if you want to buy or sell a security in the exchange market, then you have to give an order, which is your instruction to the broker or the brokerage firm, and they will then sell or purchase security on your own behalf. Now you can place this order either online or you can place it through your phone. Okay, now see, there are different types of orders based upon the restrictions that are put on price and time. I will tell you this in detail and you will be able to understand it. See, whenever a person wants to buy a security in the exchange rate, then he will go for a bid rate. What is the bid rate? Bid rate is the maximum amount that the buyer of a security is going to pay. Okay, and then we have something called as ask price. Now what is ask price? Ask price is related to selling, if you want to sell. So this is the minimum price at which someone will be ready to sell the securities. So in the exchange market, the bid and the ask rate must be equal in order to buy or sell a security. Unless there is a buyer and the seller with the same bid and ask price, then a transaction cannot happen in the exchange rate. Okay, so till now we learned that orders are instructions which are given by the investor to the broker or the brokerage firm, either online or through phone, to buy or sell the securities. Orders are important because investors themselves cannot directly participate in the stock exchange market, rather they will do it through a brokerage firm. Now a person who is wanting to buy a security has to state the bid price, which is the maximum price that he is willing to pay for the security. And a person who is wanting to sell a security has to state the ask price, which is the minimum price at which he will be able to sell the security. Now, for a transaction to happen in the securities market, the bid and the ask price must be matched. If they do not match, then no transaction can happen. Now I will tell you about the various types of orders. Okay, the first is called a market order. Now suppose you want to sell or buy a security immediately, whatever is the price at current in the market. If you want to buy your security at that price, then it is called a market order. So it is an order to buy or sell a security immediately in the market at the current price, whichever is available. Okay, so it will guarantee that your execution of your order will happen. So it is sure that your order will be executed, but there is no guarantee of price. So price will be whatever is the price prevailing currently in the market. Okay, so it is, if you are going for a sell order, if you are going for a sell order, then means it will be sold at a whatever is the current bid price. Okay, and if you are going for a buy order, then you will be able to buy at whatever is the current ask price. Okay, so in this type of order, the investor is not worried about the price. He just wants to move in or out of the security immediately. Okay. See, the investor has to remember that the last traded price may not be available to him, okay, in the market order. It can be any price which is currently prevailing. Clear? Now, the second type of order is called a limit order. Now, I told you in a market order, we will buy or sell the security at the current market price. Now, in a limit order, a specified price called limit price is given, and the execution of the trade will happen at this price only. Okay. Now, suppose you want to buy a security. When you want to buy a security, you will want to buy it at the least price. Okay. Or you won't be wanting to pay some more than a particular level. Okay. So in case of buying a security, you will state that this is the maximum price at which I will be able to buy. So if suppose the price is, suppose you say that your limit price is rupees 10. Okay. That means you won't buy the security for more than rupees 10. Okay. Now, initially, suppose the security is at rupees 12, and all of a sudden there is a point when it comes to 10. When it is coming to 10, your stockbroker will immediately buy the security on your behalf. Okay. Now, if you want to sell a security, you will want to sell it at the maximum price. So, in this case, you will give the minimum price at which you are ready to sell. For example, suppose currently the security is trading at rupees 9 and you have given your limit price as rupees 11. So, whenever the market goes to rupees 11, immediately the stockbroker will sell the security on your behalf. So, in a limit order, you will specify the price at which you are ready to buy or sell. If you want to buy, then you will give a maximum price. So, and if you want to sell, you will give a minimum price to the stockbroker. Okay. So, in the first case, in market order, you were sure that there will be execution of trade, but you were not sure of price. In case of a limit order, you will be sure of price. Okay. But no surety of trading. Okay. Why? There can be a case that the price never comes down to rupees 10. It may go to 13, 14 or 11. So there is a chance that you will never get this price. So if you don't get this price, then your order will not happen. Similarly, in the sell order, there is a chance that the security may never reach a level of rupees 11. So in that case, again, you will never be able to sell that security. Okay. Clear? Limit order is beneficial as it helps you to achieve the price objective. Okay. Now, the third type of order, I'll change the page. The third type of order is called a stop order, or you can call it a stop loss order. Okay. Now, in this case also, you will give a price which is called a stop price. Okay. So, the stop price is the price at which you will give the instruction to buy or sell. Okay. Now, I'll give you an example. Now, suppose there is an investor who has 100 shares of some company. Okay. So, this is the number of shares of a company. And the current market price per share is rupees 20. Okay. And suppose he purchased these shares at rupees 10. Fine. So a person has 100 shares of a company which he purchased at rupees 10. And the current market price is rupees 20. Okay, now the investor wants to continue holding the stock for further upsides, but also he does not want to lose if the price goes below what? Suppose say 15. So the maximum loss he's wanting to bear is 15. So I told you there is an investor who has 100 shares and he has purchased these shares at rupees 100. Currently the market price is 20. And he is expecting that the market price will go up or it will go more than 20. But there is no surety. The market price can also come down. So he says that, okay, I will take a risk. Even if it comes down, the maximum to which I will allow is rupees 15. So from 20 to rupees 15, he is able to bear the loss. But he says that, okay, if the stock goes below rupees 15, I will not hold the stock and I will sell it. So what he can do is, instead of monitoring the stock every day, he can give an order to his brokerage firm that whenever the price reaches 15, then you should sell the stock. Okay, so how is he gaining? See, if the stock price would have gone above 20, he would have gained obviously, but at rupees 15 he is setting a cutoff that I will not take any price below rupees 15. Okay, so this is how a stop order works. Now again, stop order can be a buy stop order or it can be a sell stop order. Okay, now buy stop order means you want to buy a stock, okay, and you will want to buy the stock at the minimum price. So suppose the current market price is rupees 20, okay, and you believe that the price will go down, okay, but there is a case that the price may go up. So to hedge the risk of price going up, you say that the stop price is rupees 22. So if the price is going below rupees 20, then it is good for you, then you will buy the stock at a price less than rupees 20. But if the price is increasing, then the maximum you are willing to pay is rupees 22. So your at stop price of rupees 22, your stock broker will buy the shares on your behalf. Okay, similarly, suppose I say again the current market price is rupees 20 and you want to sell the shares, so you will want the share price to go up, but there is a case that the share price can also go down. So you say that the maximum downfall that you can tolerate is rupees 80. Okay, and see, you are putting an opposite stop price because you don't want to bear a loss here. In case if the price of the share is going up, it is beneficial for you, but if the price of the share is going down, it is risky. So you are hedging the opposite risk that you are facing. Now if the share price went up, it is good, you will sell at the higher price. However, if the share price comes down, then you add, if it reaches rupees 18, then your stock broker will sell the shares on your behalf. Okay, so this is how a stop order works. So we have three types of market orders, three types of orders in the trading. First is a market order, in which you will buy or sell the security at the current market price and you are not much sensitive about the price. The second is a limit order, in which you will set a minimum or maximum price to execute a trade. And then there is a stop order, in which you will put a stop price which will be in the opposite direction of your trade. Okay.